بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، والعاقبة للمتقين، ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. أما بعد، قال المؤلف رحمه الله تعالى الإمام البربهاري، وقال عمر بن الخطاب رحمه الله: لا عذر لأحد في ضلالة ركبها حسبها هدى، ولا في هدى تركه حسبه ضلالا، فقد بينت الأمور وثبتت الحجة وانقطع العذر. وذلك أن السنة والجماعة قد أحكم أمر الدين كله وتبين للناس، فعلى الناس الاتباع. الإمام البربهاري رحمه الله يسيد عمر بن الخطاب رضي الله عنه، يسيد: There is no excuse for anyone going astray thinking that he is upon guidance, nor for abandoning guidance thinking it to be misguidance. Since the affairs have been made clear, the proof established, and the excuse cut off. That is because the Sunnah and the Jama'ah have consolidated and safeguarded all of the religion. It has been made clear to the people, so it is upon the people to comply and follow. And again, the statement attributed to Umar is, رضي الله عنه: لا عذر لأحد في ضلالة ركبها حسبها هدى. There is no excuse for anyone going astray thinking that he is upon guidance. وَلَا فِي هُدَى تَرَكَهُ حَسِبَهُ ضَلَالًا. Nor for abandoning guidance thinking it to be misguidance. فَقَدْ بُيِّنَتِ الْأُمُورِ وَثَبَتَتِ الْحُجَّةِ وَانْقَطَى الْعُذَرِ. So that's the statement attributed ماذا to Umar? Because the affairs have been made clear, the proof established, and the excuse cut off. Then al-Barbahari said, وَذَلِكَ أَنَّ السُّنَّ وَالْجَمَاعَةِ قَدْ أَحْكَمَ أَمْرَ الدِّينِ كُلَّهُ. That is because the Sunnah and the Jama'ah have consolidated and safeguarded all of the religion. وَتَبَيَّنَ لِلنَّاسِ, and it has been made clear to the people. فَعَلَى النَّاسِ الْاتِّبَاعِ, so it is upon the people to follow, to comply and to follow. شيخنا الشيخ ربيع سيد حفظه الله تعالى سيد وقول قول هذا الأثر عن عمر رضي الله عنه لم يسق له المؤلف إسنادا. The author did not mention a chain of narration for the saying of Umar. The author البربهاري رحمه الله تعالى did not mention a chain of narration for the narration from عمر رضي الله عنه. وقد أورده أبو القاسم في كتاب الحجة في بيان المحجة بقوله: وروي عن عمر رضي الله عنه هكذا بدون إسناد. And it was mentioned, this narration of Umar was also mentioned by Abu al-Qasim in his book الحجة في بيان المحجة. And he said, it has been narrated from Umar, that Umar, he said, and he mentioned that narration, هكذا بدون إسناد, and likewise without a chain of narration. وأخرجه ابن بطة في الإبانة الكبرى بإسناده إلى الأوزاعي. ابن بطة collected this narration, the narration of عمر, in الإبانة الكبرى with his chain to الأوزاعي. الأوزاعي said أنه بلغه أن عمر ابن الخطاب قال به وهو إسناد منقطع. And الأوزاعي said that it reached him that عمر ابن الخطاب, he said such and such. So there is a breakage in the chain of narration. How do we know immediately when we hear that there is a breakage in the chain, that the isnad is munqati? How do we know that? Immediately. Naam, we know immediately that this narration is munqati because Al-Awza'i, his name is what? Isa. Abdurrahman ibn man? La. Abdurrahman ibn Amr, when did he die? Inshallah, find that out for me for the next dars. However, نعم, هو من كبار أتباع التابعين. He is from the elders among the students of the تابعين, which is the students of the companions. So it's impossible for him to narrate directly from عمر ابن الخطاب رضي الله عنه. So we know when we hear that, أوزاعي said بلغه, that it reached him, that Umar, he said that the isnad, the chain of narration is munqati'. There's a breakage. There's a breakage between Awza'i and Umar ibn al-Khattab. It's not muttasil. So therefore, that would be considered to be weak. Who can tell me why? Why do we find the scholars, when it comes to the narrations of the companions, that alhamdulillah, we find that they also analyze the chain of narrations? With the tabi'un and the atba' al-tabi'een, alhamdulillah, the ulama, they mention the athar, except if there's a nakara, if there's some incorrect wording or meaning in the text. But however, when we find the narrations of the companions, we find many times that the ulama kadhalik yandurun fil isnad. The scholars, they also look and they analyze the isnad of the narrations of the companions. Whereas you might not find them doing that to the tabi'un and the atba' al-tabi'een. Why? Unless there's a nakara, some false meaning in the text. The reason why, ikhwan, as mentioned by Shaykh al-Albani rahimahullah, Shaykh al-Albani, he said, يَنْبَغِي أَن نُعَامِلْ آثَارَ الصَّحَابَةِ مِنْ حَيْثِ الْبَحْثِ فِي صِحَّتِهَا كَمَا نُعَامِلَ الْأَحَدِيثَ النَّبَوِيَّةِ. It is appropriate that when we deal with the narrations of the companions, as it pertains to analyzing and researching their authenticity, we deal with them like we deal with the narrations and the ahadith of the Prophet ﷺ. The reason why, brothers and sisters, because the athar of the Sahaba, the narrations of the companions are a proof. The narrations of the companions, قول الصحابي, إذا لم يوجد مخالف, if there's no one contradicting them, نعم, and it doesn't go against any text, the statement of a Sahabi is a proof. So as Shaykh al-Albani mentioned, ينبغي أن نعامل آثار الصحابة. When we deal with the narrations of the companions, من حيث البحث في صحتها, as it pertains to analyzing their authenticity, it is appropriate that we treat them كما نعامل الأحاديث النبوية, like we treat a hadith of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. وعلى كل إن الشيخ he said, فهذا الأثر لم يثبت عن عمر رضي الله عنه كما ترى. So in summary, this narration is not authentically established upon عمر, as you can see. فإن ثبت عنه, however, if it was established upon him, then how do we understand it? فيحمل على المعرض الذي لا يريد أن يعلم الحق من الباطل والهدى من الضلال. So when عمر he said, there is no excuse for anyone going astray, thinking that he is upon guidance, nor for abandoning guidance, thinking it to be misguidance, since the affairs have been made clear, the proof established and the excuse cut off. Shaykh Rabi, he said, this is to be understood, al al-mu'rid, to refer to the one who intentionally turns away from the truth. He does not desire to know the truth from falsehood, nor guidance from misguidance. So again, فَيُحْمَلُ عَلَى الْمُعْرِدِ الَّذِي لَا يُرِيدُ أَنْ يَعْلَمَ الْحَقِّ مِنَ الْبَاطِلِ وَالْهُدَى مِنَ الضَّلَالِ. It is to be understood to refer to the one who intentionally turns away, who does not desire to know the truth from falsehood, nor guidance from misguidance. أَمَّا مَنْ يُرِيدَ الْحَقِّ وَيُحِبُّهُ فَيَقَعُ فِي الضَّلَالِ وَإِنْ كَانَ مِنَ الْمُجْتَهِدِينَ وَبَذَلَ أَقْصَى جُهْدِهِ لِلْوَصُولِ إِلَى الْحَقِّ فَلَمْ يَهْتَدِ إِلَيْهِ فهذا يصدق عليه قول رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إذا حكم الحاكم فاجتهد ثم أصاب فله أجران وإذا حكم فاجتهد ثم أخطأ فله أجر. As for the one who desires the truth, he wants the truth and loves it, yet he falls into misguidance, then if they are from the scholars who are able to make ijtihad, scholarly deduction, and they try their utmost to reach the truth, but they do not attain it, then the saying of the Prophet ﷺ would apply to them. And the hadith that the Shaykh is referring to is the saying of the Prophet ﷺ, when the judge, he makes a judgment, endeavoring to arrive at the truth, and he is correct, then he will receive two rewards. With a hakama fajtahad, and if he makes a judgment, and he endeavors to attain the truth, but he is mistaken, then he will receive one reward. So, that is with regards to the one who wants the truth, he loves it, but he falls into misguidance if he is from the mujtahideen, the scholars who are able to perform ijtihad, scholarly deduction of the texts. وَهَذَا الْأَجْرَ الْوَاحِدِ الْمُجْتَهِدَ الْمُخْتِي هُوَ مُقَابِلُ إِجْتِهَادِهِ. This one reward is for the scholar who is a mujtahid, who is mistaken, and this is for him endeavoring to arrive at the truth. So what this one reward is for the scholar who is able to make ijtihad, who is mistaken, is due to his effort to attain the truth. وَيَعْذُرُهُ اللَّهُ فِي خَطَئِهِ. And Allah Azza wa Jalla will pardon him for his mistake. وَقَدْ عَلَّمَ اللَّهُ عِبَادَهُ أَنْ يَدْعُوهُ فَيَقُولُ. And Allah taught his servants to say, to supplicate to him and say, ربنا لا تؤاخذنا إن نسينا أو أخطأنا. That dua, oh our Lord, do not take us to account if we make a mistake or if we forget. ربنا لا تؤاخذنا إن نسينا أو أخطأنا. Oh our Lord, do not take us to account if we forget or we make a mistake. وقال كما في الحديث الصحيح, and Allah عز وجل said, as comes in the hadith Qudsi, قد فعلت, I have done this. وإن كان جاهلا, so let's look, we have three categories of people. We have the one who turns away from the truth, he doesn't want it. He doesn't want to know the truth from the falsehood, no guidance from misguidance, and this statement of Umar applies to him. There is no excuse for anyone going astray, thinking that he is upon guidance, nor for abandoning guidance, thinking it to be misguidance, since the affairs have been made clear, the proof established, and the excuse cut off. طيب. Then you have the scholar who is from the mujtahidun. He falls into misguidance. However, he endeavored, he tried his best to arrive at the truth. Then this scholar, he will receive one reward due to his effort to arrive at the truth. Naam, and Allah Azza wa Jalla will pardon him for his mistake. Then the third category is the jahil, the one who is ignorant. The one who is ignorant. وَإِنْ كَانَ جَاهِلًا وَيُحِبَّ الْحَقِّ. But he loves the truth. He is ignorant, but he loves the truth. وَيُرِيدُهُ, and he desires it, he wants it. وَلَكِنْ لَمْ يَجِدْ مَنْ يَدُلُّهُ عَلَى الْحَقِّ. He doesn't find no one to direct him to the truth. نعم. He doesn't find anyone to direct him to the truth. وَلَمْ يَهْتَدِي إِلَيْهِ بِنَفْسِهِ. And he can't arrive at the truth by himself. كَحَدِيثِ الْعَهْدِ بِالْإِسْلَامِ. Like the new Muslim. A new Muslim, he loves the truth. He's ignorant, he loves the truth, he wants the truth, but he can't find anyone to direct him and point him in that, the right direction. And he cannot arrive at the truth by himself. أو مَنْ يَنْشَأُ فِي بَادِيَةٍ بَعِيدًا عَنْ أَهْلِ الْعِلْمِ. Or like someone who lives in a remote region, far away from the scholars. فَهَذَا يَعْذُرُهُ اللَّهِ لِجَهْلِهِ كَمَا قَرَّرَ ذَلِكَ الْعُلَمَاءِ. Then this type of person, the scholars have mentioned, Allah Azza wa Jalla will excuse him because of his ignorance. Allah Azza wa Jalla will pardon him due to his ignorance, because he loves the truth, he wants the truth, na'am, but he doesn't find anyone to direct him to the truth. And he can't arrive at it himself. And the Shaykh said, and this has been stated by the scholars, because Allah Azza wa Jalla, he said, وَمَنْ يُشَاقِقِ الرَّسُولَ مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا تَبَيَّنَ لَهُ الْهُدَى وَيَتَّبِعْ غَيْرَ سَبِيلِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ نُوَلِّهِ مَا تَوَلَّى وَنُصْلِهِ جَهَنَّمْ وَسَاءَتْ مَصِيرًا. Whoever opposes the messenger after guidance has been made clear to him and follows a path other than the path of the believers, we shall land him in hell upon that path that he has chosen. And what an evil destination, what an evil abode he has chosen for himself. Na'am. My question, Ikhwan, how is that a dalil for what the Shaykh mentioned? The ayah. Tfaddal. Musa'ab, tfaddal. Na'am, because Allah Azza wa Jal, subhanahu wa ta'ala, in this ayah, he said, وَمَنْ يُشَاقِقِ الرَّسُولَ مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا تَبَيَّنَ لَهُ الْهُدَى. After guidance has been made clear to him. نعم. And he follows a path other than the path of the believers. So that person, guidance is clear to him. وَهَذَا الْجَاهِلَ الْمُحِبْ لِلْحَقِّ لَا يَنْطَبِقْ عَلَيْهِ هَذَا الدَّمِ وَالْوَعِيدِ وَإِنَّمَا يَنْطَبِقْ عَلَى مَنْ لَا يُرِيدِ الْحَقَّ وَيَتَّبِعُ هَوَاهَا. So the ignorant person who loves the truth, then this rebuke and threat does not apply to him. Rather, it applies to the one who does not want the truth and he follows his desires. May Allah Azza protect us all from that. Because look, the wa'id is shadeed. Naam, the wa'id is shadeed. And Shaykh al-Fawzani said, Habidahullah ta'ala, with regards to the statement of Umar, when Umar, he said, فَقَدْ بُيِّنَتِ الْأُمُورِ, that the affairs have been made clear. So again, this is the narration upon Umar. لَا عُذْرَ لِأَحَدٍ فِي ضَلَالَةٍ رَكِبَهَا حَسِبَهَا هُدَى. There is no excuse for anyone who goes astray thinking that he is upon guidance. وَلَا فِي هُدَى تَرَكَهُ حَسِبَهُ ضَلَالًا. Nor for abandoning guidance, thinking it to be misguidance. فَقَدْ بُيِّنَتِ الْأُمُورِ. The affairs have been made clear. Since the affairs have been made clear, Shaykh al-Fawzan said, نَعَمْ قَدْ بُيِّنَتِ الْأُمُورِ. The affairs, yes, certainly they have been made clear. لكنها تحتاج إلى بحث وإلى طلب. But it requires research. You have to seek it out. You have to seek it out. You can't be at home, your feet on the couch, and you're watching all types of nonsense on the tilfaz, the television. لا تتعلم دينك. You're not learning your religion. You don't learn the Quran. You don't learn how to recite it. You don't learn how to understand it. You don't learn the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And then you expect everything, ماذا, for you to understand the affairs. How? The Shaykh, he said, لكنها تحتاج إلى بحث وإلى طلب. It requires research and you have to seek it. بأن يتعلم الإنسان. A person has to learn ويتفقه and seek understanding in the religion ويأخذ العلم العلماء and to take knowledge from the scholars. Allahu Akbar. If somebody wants to be upon what is correct, نعم, the affairs have been made clear. However, you have to seek knowledge. لازم أن تطلب العلم. You have to seek knowledge. At the same time, how do we go about seeking knowledge? It's not just about opening a book, saying I'm going to seek knowledge and you don't know anything. Or it's not about opening up and looking on Google because you don't know what you're going to come across. That's not the tariqah that you seek knowledge. As Shaykh al-Fawzan said, a person must seek knowledge. He must gain understanding in the religion. وَيَأْخُذَ الْعِلْمَ عَنِ الْعُلَمَىٰ And he must take knowledge from the scholars. وَلَا يَأْخُذَ الْعِلْمَ عَنْ نَفْسِهِ أو عَنْ مِثْلِهِ مِنَ الْجُحَارِ He should not take knowledge from his own self or rely upon the like of him, someone similar to him from the ignorant people. And that's the problem in this time. Ikhwan, people, they rush. مَا عِنْدُوا شَيْ مَا عِنْدُوا شَيْ He rushes, يَسْتَعْجِلْ to make a video and put it on YouTube. And he says, I'm teaching the people their religion. إِذَا لَمْ تَسْطَحِ فَاسْنَعْ مَا شِئْ If you have no shame, do as you please. That's a musibah. The new thing now, have a maktaba behind you, have nice books in the maktaba, put a camera in front of you, خلاص, and claim تَدَّعِ أَنَّكَ تُدَرِّسَ النَّاسِ that you're teaching the people, and so on and so forth. الشيخ الفوزان said, بِأَنْ يَتَعَلَّمَ الْإِنسَانِ وَيَأْخُذَ الْعِلْمَ عَنِ الْعُلَمَاءِ To take knowledge from the scholars, to not take knowledge from the like of him. So if you see someone is like you and he's putting himself forward and you know that he's min al-juhar, don't take knowledge from him. أو من المتعالمين, or he's somebody that pretends to have knowledge. أو من الكتب, just relying on books. Sole reliance on books, no. بَلْ يَأْخُذَ الْعِلْمَ عَنْ أَهْلِهِ Rather, he must take knowledge from its people. لأن هذا العلم يتلقى عن العلماء because this knowledge is taken from the scholars فالعلم بالتلقي knowledge is taken from the علماء وليس بالأخذ من الكتب not just solely relying upon books that is one of the reasons why many of the people in this time they have strayed from the truth because they have solely relied upon books and you hear all types of عجائب and غرائب strange things And that is what the scholars, they say, مَنْ دَخَلَ فِي غَيْرِ فَنِّهِ أَتَى بِالْعَجَاءِ وَالْغَرَائِبِ If somebody talks about a science or a knowledge that he is not familiar with, he is not firm in, you will hear amazing things from that type of person. الْكُتَبْ إِنَّمَا هِيَ أَدَوَاتِ Books, they are tools. فَقَدْ لِبَحْثِ For research. يَشْرَحُهَا الْعُلَمَى The scholars, they explain them. أما الوصول إلى الحق as for arriving at the truth فهذا يؤخذ عن أهل العلم then it is to be learned from the scholars ويروى عنهم and it is conveyed from them خلفا عن سلف generation after generation the previous generations the latter generations they take from the previous generations هكذا العلم that is the way to seek knowledge and then البربهاري رحمه الله he goes on to say وعلم رحمك الله no may Allah have mercy upon you look he wants good for you making dua for you. And we mentioned that this is from the way of the believers. To make dua for your brother. Rahimakullah. May Allah have mercy upon you. And that alhamdulillah we find the scholars, many of the scholars, mother, opening their books in the same way. I'lam rahimakullah. No, may Allah have mercy upon you. Why? Because the ulama, they want good for the ummah. They want good for the ummah. They want, you read al-khayr lil-nas. Not wanting bad for the people or evil for your brothers and your sisters upon mother, upon the sunnah. And that is why the scholars, they mention that one of the first ahadith that the sheikh would narrate to his student, al-hadith al-musalsal, is the hadith, irhamu man fil ard, yarhamka man fil sama. Have mercy upon those who are in the earth, and the one who is above the heavens will have mercy upon you. And that hadith, they say, is musalsal bil-awwaliyya. That would be the first hadith that they would narrate to their students about rahmah. Because learning is based upon rahmah, mercy. You want good for the person. يَتَعَلَّمْ, that he learns, alhamdulillah, يَسْتَقِيمْ, that he is upright, يَهْتَدِي, إِلَىٰ آخِرِهِ. You don't want evil for that person. You don't want bad for him. So al-Barbahari, he said, إِعْلَمْ رَحِمَكَ اللَّهِ. No, may Allah have mercy upon you. أَنَّ الدِّينِ إِنَّمَا جَاءَ مِنْ قِبَلِ اللَّهِ تَبَارَكَ وَتَعَالَى. That the religion is only what come from Allah, the blessed, the most high. Naam, the religion is only what come from Allah, the blessed and most high. لَمْ يُوضَ عَلَى عُقُولِ الرِّجَالِ وَآرَائِهِمْ. The religion is not left to the intellects of men and their opinions. وَعِلْمُهُ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ وَعِنْدَ رَسُولِهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ. Knowledge of the religion is what comes from Allah and His Messenger, صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ. فَلَا تَتَّبِعْ شَيْئًا بِهَوَاكْ فَتَمْرُقَ مِنَ الدِّينِ فَتَخْرُجَ مِنَ الْإِسْلَامِ. وَالْعِيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ. Al-Barbahari, he said, so do not follow anything based on your desires. Look at that. Look at the khatr, the danger. Do not follow anything based upon your desires. And as a result, depart from the religion and leave Islam. May Allah protect us from that. فَإِنَّهُ لَا حُجَّةَ لَكْ. Verily, there is no excuse for you. فَقَدْ بَيَّنَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ لِأُمَّتِيَ السُّنَّةِ وَأَوْضَحَ لِأَصْحَابِهِ وَهُمَ الْجَمَاعَةِ وَهُمَ السَّوَادَ الْأَعْظَمُ وَالسَّوَادَ الْأَعْظَمُ الْحَقُّ وَأَهْلُهُ. فَمَنْ خَالَفَ أَصْحَابَ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ فِي شَيْءٍ مِنْ أَمْرِ دِينٍ فَقَدْ كَفَرَ. Al-Barbahari said, there is no excuse for you. صلى الله عليه وسلم explained the sunnah to his nation and clarified it to his companions, and they are the jama'ah. They are the main body. And the main body, as-sawad al-a'zam, is the truth and its people. So whoever contradicts the companions of the Messenger of Allah, صلى الله عليه وسلم, in any of the affairs of the religion, then he has fallen into disbelief. So we'll explain that paragraph from Al-Imam Al-Barbahari rahimahullah. Na'am. So in this passage, Al-Barbahari yuhadhiru al-mu'allifu rahimahullah min ittiba'i al-hawa. The author is warning against following one's desires. The author is warning against following one's desires. ويحث على اتباع ما أوحاه الله إلى محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم والاستسلام والانقياد لكل ما جاء به محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم لأنه هو الدين الحق الذي لا يقبل الله دينا سواه. The author is warning against following one's desires and encouraging us to follow that which Allah revealed to Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم and to submit and surrender to everything that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam came with. Because it is the religion of Allah. It is the true religion. And Allah azza wa jalla will not accept any other religion. وَاللَّهُ مَا شَرَعَ هَذَا الدِّينَ لِيُوَافِقَ أَهْوَاءَ النَّاسِ وَرَغَبَاتِهِمْ وَشَهَوَاتِهِمْ. Allah azza wa jalla did not legislate the religion to conform with the desires, the wants and the lusts of the people. Allah azza wa jalla did not legislate this religion to conform with the desires, the wants, and the lusts of the people. And that's haq. The religion is what? Al-Barbahari, he said, وَأَعْلَمْ رَحِمَكُ اللَّهِ أَنَّ الدِّينِ إِنَّمَا جَاءَ مِنْ قِبَلِ اللَّهِ. The religion, it came from Allah. تَبَارَكَ وَتَعَالَى. لَمْ يُوضَ عَلَى عُقُولِ الرِّجَالِ وَأَرَائِهِمْ. The religion is not left to the intellects and the opinions of the people. So when you hear sentiments and statements like, we are going to create our own madhab, school of thought, for us in this situation. We want our own understanding of Islam in accordance to our raghabat, wants. You know that's dhalala. Without even looking into it, you know the mabda is fasid. It's corrupt, false. Why? Because أَنَّ الدِّينِ إِنَّمَا جَاءَ مِنْ قِبَلِ اللَّهِ. The religion, it came from Allah Azza wa Jal. لَمْ يُوضَ عَلَى أُقُولِ الرِّجَالِ وَأَرَائِهِمْ. The religion is not left to the intellect and the opinions of men. The religion is what is in the Qur'an and the Sunnah, with the understanding of the Salaf of this Ummah. The Shaykh, he mentioned the ayah, Allah Azza wa Jalla, he said, تَبَارَكَ وَتَعَالَى, يُرِيدُ اللَّهُ لِيُبَيِّنَ لَكُمْ وَيَهْدِيَكُمْ سُنَنَ الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ وَيَتُوبَ عَلَيْكُمْ وَاللَّهُ عَلِيمٌ حَكِيمٌ. Allah wants to make clear to you and to show you the ways of those before you. And Allah Azza wa Jalla, He wants to accept your repentance, and Allah is the All-Knower, the All-Wise. نعم والله يريد أن يتوب عليكم ويريد الذين يتبعون الشهوات أن تميلوا ميلا عظيما. الله عز وجل تبارك وتعالى, He wants to accept your repentance, but those who follow their lusts, they want you to deviate clearly from the right path, from the truth. So here in this verse, Allah Azza wa Jalla clearly tells us, وَيُرِيدُ الَّذِينَ يَتَّبِعُونَ الشَّهَوَاتِ, those people, they follow their lust, they want you to deviate far away from the path, the true path. وَالدِّينِ فِيهِ أُمُورٌ غَيْبِيَّةٌ لَا تُدْرِكُهَا الْعُقُولِ. In the religion, there are matters of the unseen which cannot be arrived at by the intellects. You cannot arrive at them by your aql. There are matters of the unseen. The only way that you can fathom them is by the text of the Quran and the Sunnah. I'll give an example. The angels. Can you see the angels? How do you believe in them? It's based on the Quran and the Sunnah. The grave. Can you see the punishment of the grave? No, you can't. How do we believe in it? It's based upon the Quran and the Sunnah. So in the religion, there are matters of the unseen which cannot be arrived at by the intellects. The names and the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, likewise, are from the matters of the unseen. We believe in them based upon the text of the Quran and the Sunnah, as befitting His Majesty. So in the religion, there are matters of the unseen which cannot be arrived at by the intellect. So it is obligatory to believe in them and submit to them, even if it cannot be arrived at by the intellects. وَمِنَا تَشْرِعَاتِ يدرك العلماء عللها وحكمها التي اشتملت عليها. Also in the religion, there are legislative rulings which the scholars can understand their reasons and the wisdoms behind them. And there are also rulings that the scholars cannot decipher the reasons and its wisdoms. I'll give an example. على سبيل المثال, نعم, something that we know the wisdom of. Going to sleep after Isha. What is from the wisdoms of that? متوكل. نعم. So that you can wake up in time for Fajr. So there are wisdoms. And we know some of the wisdoms. Likewise, wudu, there are wisdoms behind wudu. Some of the wisdoms behind wudu is that when you make wudu, it washes away the sins. As comes in the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So there are hikam, wisdoms, and there are reasons, نعم, that as it pertains to the rulings, legislative rulings, that the scholars, they understand some of them. However, there also are rulings that the scholars, they may not understand the reasons or the wisdoms behind them. Like for example, why do we pray Ya Mus'ab 5 times and not 50 times? What's the wisdom behind that? We don't know. However, alhamdulillah, we believe in it and we accept it. So there, فَيَجِبَ الْإِيمَانَ بِهَا وَالتَّسْلِيمُ لَهَا. It's obligatory that we believe in them and we submit to them, whether we know the wisdoms or whether we don't. Even as it pertains to the tashri'at, the legislative rulings. وَهَذَا هُوَ مَنْهَجُ السَّلَفَ الصَّالِحِ. And that is the methodology of the rightly guided predecessors as it pertains to the text of the sharia of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. And that is the position of Ahlul Sunnah. أَمَّا أَهْلِ الْأَهْوَاءِ وَالضَّلَالِ وَالْكَلَامِ وَالْفَلْسَفَةِ فَيُقَدِّمُونَ عُقُولُهُمْ عَلَى النُّصُوصِ الْإِلَهِيَّةِ وَالنَّبَوِيَّةِ. As for the people of desires, misguidance, and speculative rhetoric and philosophy, then they give precedence to their intellects over the divine texts. Naam. Ahlul Bidah, Ahlul Sunnah, Nuqaddim al-Naql al-Aql. We give precedence to the texts. We give precedence to the texts. Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu an, kama thabata anhu fi Sunan Abi Dawud, as is established in Sunan Abi Dawud, he said, radiallahu an, لو كان الدين بالرأي. If religion was based upon, if the religion of Islam was based solely upon one's intellect, opinions, لكان أسفل الخف, then the bottom of the leather sock, it would be more deserving to be wiped than the top. And I saw the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam wipe the top of the khuf, because you walk on the bottom gets dirty. So if it was just upon your aql, your ra'i, your intellect and your reasoning, if it was solely that and nothing else, somebody may say, but then you walk on the bottom of your feet. You walk on the bottom of the sock. So if you're going to clean anything, then maybe you should clean the bottom. If it was just upon what? Speculative reasoning and kalam. However, he said, لو كان الدين بالرأي. If the religion was based upon merely the intellect, then the bottom would be more deserving than to be wiped than the top. But he said, I saw the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam wipe the top. And the people of Bid'ah, they give precedence to what? Their aql, their intellect, over the texts. They say if something they find in the Quran or the Sunnah, It goes against their aql. They can't understand it. They reject it. So like, we'll give an example. The Mu'tazila, وَمَنْ تَشَبَّهَ بِهِمْ, and those who resemble them, they say, when you dig up the grave, you don't see no punishment. You don't see no na'im. You don't see anything happening in the grave. So how can we believe in the punishment of the grave? We don't believe in that. وَالْعِيَادُ بِاللَّهِ. Look at the corruption in their aql. Why? Because they give their intellect precedence over the nusus. Another example. Allah Azza wa Jal, Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, He said, وَكَلَّمَ اللَّهُ مُوسَى تَكْلِيمًا. Allah Azza wa Jal, He spoke to Musa with speech. He spoke to Musa with speech. And He emphasized it, تَكْلِيمًا مَفْعُولٌ مُطْلَقٌ. Allah Azza wa Jal, He spoke directly to Musa with speech. The people of innovation, they say, no, Allah does not speak. Why do they say that? They say, because if you were to say that Allah speaks, وَتَعَالُ اللَّهُ عَمَّا يَقُولُونَ عُلُوًا كَبِيرًا, and Allah is far removed from what they say about Him and what they think about Him. Because هَؤُلَى مُشَبِّهَا, in reality, they are the ones, they resemble Allah to the creation. They say, if you say Allah speaks, then what you're saying is Allah has a tongue, He has a voice box, He has this, He has that, وَالْعِيَادُ بِاللَّهِ. Look how corrupt their intellect is. So the people of innovation, they say, Ahl al-Bida from the Jahmiyyah and those who are like them, they say Allah Azza wa Jal, He does not speak. And kalam, speech, is not from His attributes, the attributes of Allah Azza wa Jal. Why? Because if we were to affirm that speech is from the attributes of Allah Azza wa Jal and Allah Azza wa Jal speaks in a way befitting His majesty, then that would necessitate that Allah Azza wa Jal, He has a tongue, He has a voice box, and so on and so forth. Which is batil. Allah Azza wa Jal in the Quran, He said, وَكَلَّمَ اللَّهُ مُوسَى تَكْلِيمًا. Allah, He spoke directly to Musa. So we affirm what Allah affirms for Himself. We affirm what Allah Azza wa Jal affirms for Himself. And it does not mean, if we affirm for Allah Azza wa Jal the attribute of speech, it does not mean what they claim. It does not mean what they claim. Because Yawm al-Qiyam, Allah Azza wa Jal, He will make our limbs speak. Our limbs. Do you have a tongue in your limb? La. So it does not necessitate their false claims to begin with. Secondly, لَيْسَ كَمِثْلِهِ شَيْءٍ. There is nothing like Allah Azza wa Jal. So why are they resembling Allah Azza wa Jal to the creation? That's their first khata, wadih. They resemble Allah Azza wa Jal to the creation. So in order to escape that, they deny the names and attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَالْعِيَادُ بِاللَّهِ. They deny the names of Allah Azza wa Jal, the names and attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To the extent, because of that, they are even willing to distort even what comes in the Quran. They're willing, as it comes to the Quran, they try to change it. Because they changed the ayah from وكلم الله موسى تكليما, they changed it to وكلم الله موسى تكليما. They claimed that والعياذ بالله that موسى was the فاعل and لفظ الجلال was the مفعول به, so the meaning would be according to their how they tried to distort it, and موسى spoke to Allah. أعوذ بالله. Look at that. Because of the corruption in their عقل, they tried to distort the book of Allah عز وجل. نعم. So Sheikh Rabi, he said, as for the people of desires and misguidance and speculative rhetoric and philosophy, then they give precedence to their intellect over the divine texts and the ahadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. وَيَزْعُمُونَ أَنَّ الْعَقْلَ يُفِيدَ الْيَقِينَ وَنُسُوسُ الشَّرْعِ لَا تُفِيدَ الْيَقِينَ. And they claim that the intellect, it leads to certainty, and the legislated texts do not convey certainty. فَيُقَدَّمْ عَلَيْهَا. So therefore the intellect, we give a precedence over the texts. وَيَزْعُمُونَ أَنَّ الْعَقْلَ هُوَ الْأَصَلُ فَإِذَا تَعَارَضَتِ النُّصُوصُ الشَّرْعِيَّةُ مَعَ الْعَقْلِ وَجَبَ رَدَّ الشَّرْعِ إِلَى الْعَقْلِ. And they claim that the foundation is the intellect. So if the texts of the Quran or the Sunnah contradict the intellect, oppose the intellect, then it's obligatory that we return the texts to the understanding of what? To the intellect. وَكَمْ قَدْ اخْتَلَفَتْ عُقُولُهُمْ وَتَضَارَبَتْ آرَاؤُهُمْ فأي عقل منها يكون هو المرجع والحكم قاتل الله الأهواء وأهلها. Sheikh Rabi said, he said, how many different opinions the people have? How many different understandings and intellects do they have? So what intellect is the reference point that we return to? Whose intellect? Whose intellect? Whose intellect do we return back to? Whose judgment is the final judgment? May Allah Azza wa Jal exterminate desires and his people. وَالْحَقْ أَنَّ الشَّرْعُ هُوَ الْهُدَى. The truth of the matter that the text of the Qur'an and the Sunnah is guidance. The text of the Qur'an and the Sunnah is guidance. وَفِيهِ النُّورِ. And in them is light. وَنُصُوصِ الْقُرْآنِيَةُ تُفِيدَ الْيَقِينِ. And the text in the Qur'an and the Sunnah, they lead to certainty. No doubt. Likewise, the ahadith which are mutawatira, والأحاديث التي تلقتها الأمة بالقبول تفيد العلم اليقيني عند أهل الحديث وكثير من علماء الفرق وهو الواقع. And likewise, the ahadith that reached the level of mutawatir and the ahadith that this nation have unanimously accepted, according to the scholars of hadith and many of the scholars even of the sects, they lead to certainty. Likewise, they convey certainty, certain knowledge. And this is the reality. And I'll explain that, Ikhwan, inshallah, I'll try and simplify it for you. The people of Bid'ah, they say that, the people of innovation and misguidance, they say the ahadith, la tufid al-yaqeen, they don't lead us to certain knowledge. Because it's possible that this hadith, it could be correct, and it's possible it could be a kadhib, it could be a lie. So here, tufid al-dhan. So in reality, it's just speculation, and not certain knowledge that we get from these ahadith. So therefore, based upon that, ahadith al-ahad, those ahadith that don't reach the level of mutawatir, we don't accept them in aqeedah. So therefore, we don't believe in the punishment of the grave. We don't believe, mother, in anything that is conveyed by these type of ahadith, ahadith al-ahad. So they reject many aspects of the religion with this argument. Wal-iyadu billah. We don't accept these ahadith that affirm names for Allah, or that affirm attributes for Allah Azza wa Jal. Why? Because these ahadith, they only give a speculation, not certainty. They could be correct, they may be incorrect. It's not certain knowledge. So the Mu'tazila, they came with this filthy idea to reject the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, which is nonsense. All of the ulama, they agreed that sah al-hadith wa madhabi. If the hadith is sahih, it's my madhab. As for this distinction between mutawatir and ahad, in accepting it in matters of aqidah, it's mardood. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he sent Mu'ad ibn Jabal to Yemen to teach the people Islam. Call them to la ilaha illallah. Mu'ad ibn Jabal, he was one or he was mutawatir? He was one. Ahad. Na'am. So this distinction that they come with, it's misguidance, but it's to reject the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and it's engineered to what? Give precedence to the intellect over the texts. That's the plot behind it. The plot behind it is to give precedence to the aql over the nusus. And many of the scholars you find, brothers and sisters, this is one of the major differences between Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah. One of the major differences between Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah, masadir al-talaqi. Where do we take our religion from? Ahl Sunnah, قرآن سنة إجماع. أهل البدع the intellect is first even over the Quran and the Sunnah, and that's why many of the scholars they start with this. Even Ibn Abi Dawud in Al-Ha'iyya تمسك بحبل الله واتبع الهدى ولا تكو بدعيا لعلك تفلح. Hold on to the rope of Allah, تمسك بحبل الله واتبع الهدى, and follow the huda, follow the guidance of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and don't be a person upon innovation. Base your religion upon Quran, Sunnah, understanding of Sahaba. That's مصادر التلقي عند أهل السنة, Quran, Sunnah, إجماع, and there's some other affairs. As for أهل البدع, the precedence is عقل, intellect. That's the foundation. And everything else is in accordance to their intellects. The heads of these movements, these intellectual misguided movements, wallahi, they live their whole lives in confusion. They live their whole lives in confusion, going from one opinion to another opinion, because like Imam Malik said, every time a person comes to us and he's better than argumentation, are we going to follow him and leave what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam came with? That is why this statement, I heard somebody say a statement, الَّذِي ضَلَّ عَنِ السِّرَاطِ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ, somebody who strayed from the straight path, he said, I'm a champion of the people. What does that mean, you're a champion of the people? We are champions of Kitab and Sunnah, with understanding of the Salaf of this Ummah. So Al-Barbahari, he said, فَلَا تَتَّبِعْ شَيْئًا بِهَوَاكْ فَتَمْرُقَ مِنَ الدِّينِ. Do not follow anything based on your desires, and as a result, depart from the religion and leave Islam. اتِّبَاعَ الْهَوَى, following your desires, قد يؤدي إلى الكفر. It may lead a person to disbelief. إذا كان معاندا ومستحلا لمخالفة نصوص الشرع. Following desires may lead to disbelief if the individual is stubborn in opposition of the truth and he declares it lawful to oppose the texts. It could lead a person to kufr. وقد يؤدي إلى الضلال. And it may not lead a person to disbelief, but it may lead him to misguidance. إذا كان يحترم نصوص الشرع. If the individual respects the text of the Quran and the Sunnah, ويقع في المخالفات, but he falls into errors and oppositions, وهو غير مستحيل, but he does not declare this to be lawful, لكنه لغلبة الهوى, however this arises due to his desires and lusts, ولا حجة لهذا وذاك في مخالفة الشرع, and there is no excuse for this one nor that one in opposing the truth. Now the Sheikh said, following desires may lead to disbelief if the individual is stubborn. If the individual is stubborn in opposition to the truth and he declares it lawful to oppose the text of the Quran and the Sunnah. However, it may not lead a person to disbelief following one's desires, but it still leads to misguidance. And that's if the individual, he respects the text of the Quran and the Sunnah, but he falls into matters of opposition without him declaring this to be lawful. Meaning he doesn't make istihlal. He doesn't say it's lawful for him. However, this is due to his desires and lusts. There is no excuse for this one nor that one. As Al-Barbahari, he said, فَقَدْ بَيَّنَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَمْ لِأُمَّتِيَ السُنَّةَ وَأَوْضَحَهَا لِأَصْحَابِي. Because the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم has explained the Sunnah to his nation and clarified it to his companions. وَهَذَا تَعْلِيلِ قَوْلِهِ. And this is an explanation to his statement, فَإِنُّهُ لَا حُجَّةَ لَكْ. There is no excuse for you. فَيَا وَيْلْ مَنْ ظَهَرَتْ لَهُ الْحُجَّةُ وَخَالَفَهَا مُتَّبِعًا لِهَوَاهُ. And woe to the one whom the proof is clear to him, but he opposes it following his desires. Woe to that individual. We fear for him. The one, the haq, ya'arif al-haq, he knows it. But he turns away from the haq because of his hawa, his desires. Ittiba' al-hawa. Wal-iyadu billah. May Allah protect us from that. As Allah Azza wa Jal, wa qala ta'ala, Allah Azza wa Jal, he said, وَمَنْ أَضَلُّ مِمَّنْ اتَّبَعَ هَوَاهُ بِغَيْرِ هُدًى مِّنَ اللَّهِ. Who is more misguided than the one he follows his desires without guidance from Allah? Who's more astray than that person? Who is more astray than the one who follows his desires without guidance from Allah, without Quran, without Sunnah, with the understanding of the Sahaba? Inna Allah la yahdi al-qawm al-zalimin. Allah Azza wa Jal guides not the people who are wrongdoers, the zalimin. Also Allah Azza wa Jal said, وَلَا تَتَّبِعِ الْهَوَى فَيُضِلَّكَ عَن سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ. Do not follow your desires because your desires will misguide you from the straight path. Do not follow your desires because your desires will misguide you from the straight path. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يَضِلُّونَ عَن سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ لَهُمْ عَذَابٌ شَدِيدٌ بِمَا نَسُوا يَوْمَ الْحِسَابِ. Verily those, they stray, they deviate from the path of Allah, they shall have a severe torment. Look, Don't follow your desires because your desires will lead you away from the straight path. Mujahadat al-nafs, striving against your soul, striving against your desires. Inna alladhina yadhilluna an sabilillah, because verily those who deviate from the path of Allah, for them is a severe torment. A severe torment because they forgot the day of reckoning. They forgot Yawm al-Qiyamah. Then al-Barbahari, he said, rahimahullah, وَهُمَ الْجَمَاعَةِ, and they are the jama'ah. They are the jama'ah. Verily the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he explained the sunnah to his nation and clarified it to his companions. And they are the jama'ah. And they are as-sawad al-a'zam, the main body of Muslims. Was-sawad al-a'zam, who are the main body? The main body, al-Barbahari, he said, al-haq wa ahluhu. Look. That's understanding. This is a nice introduction, Ikhwan. A beautiful introduction in these points. The first few points that we have taken so far, this is point number 5. Who are as-sawad al-a'zam? Who's the main body? Some people will say the main body is the majority of the Muslims. Al-Barbahari, he said, as-sawad al-a'zam al-haq wa ahluhu. This as-sawad al-a'zam is the truth and the people of the truth. And we're going to read a nice narration that Sheikh Al-Fawzan, he brings in his explanation in a minute, inshallah ta'ala, concerning this. Na'am. Al-Sheikh Rabi, he said, commenting upon that. يعني أن الصحابة هم الجماعة. The companions, they are the جماعة. فمن خالفهم وقع في جاهلية وضلال. Whoever opposes the companions falls into ignorance and misguidance. لأنه اتبع غير سبيل المؤمنين. Because he followed other than the path of the believers. والله توعد من يتبع غير سبيلهم. And Allah threatens with a punishment the one who follows other than the path of the companions. ثُمَّ إِنَّ أَهْلِ الْحَقِّ هُمَ الْجَمَاعَةِ فِي أَيِّ زَمَانٍ وَأَيِّ مَكَانٍ. Furthermore, the people of the truth, they are the jama'ah in every time and every place. Wherever you find them, whether they're in China, whether they're in America, whether they're in Saudi Arabia, wherever you find them, the people of the truth, نعم, they are the jama'ah. وَلَوْ كَانُوا قِلَّةً, even if they are the minority. فَلَيْسَ الْعِبْرَى فِي الْإِسْلَامِ بِالْكَثْرَةِ. Because the crucial factor, the determining factor in Islam is not the majority. Don't use the majority as a proof. The majority in al-Islam is not the ibra. It is not the determining factor. It is not the crucial factor, the majority. Rather, the crucial factor is following the truth. As Allah Azza wa Jalla said, and these are some of the proofs, these are some of the proofs that the crucial, the determining factor is not the majority. That which matters that you follow the haqq, not that you follow the majority. Listen, Allah Azza wa Jalla said, وَإِن تُطِعْ أَكْثَرَ مَن فِي الْأَرْضِ يُضِلُّكَ عَن سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ. If you were to follow the majority of the people, if you were to follow the majority of the people on the earth, they would misguide you from the path of Allah. إِن يَتَّبِعُونَ إِلَّا الظَّنَّ وَإِن هُمْ إِلَّا يَخْرُصُونَ. They only follow speculation and conjecture, and they do nothing but lying. So look in this verse. وَإِن تُطِعْ أَكْثَرَ مَن فِي الْأَرْضِ. If you were to obey the majority of the people on the earth, يُضِلُّكَ عَن سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ. They would misguide you from the path of Allah, the straight path. إِن يَتَّبِعُونَ إِلَّا الظَّنَّ. Because the majority of the people on the earth, they follow only conjecture. Majority of the people on the earth, the majority of the people, إِلَّا مَن رَحِمَ اللَّهِ, they follow what the next person is doing. They're not analyzing it in light of Quran and Sunnah, with understanding of the Salaf of the Ummah. It's about the majority. Or the majority of people are on Instagram, let me jump on Instagram. The majority of people are doing this, let me start doing this. The majority of the people that are doing this, let me start doing that. That's the mentality amongst the majority of the people, إِلَّا مَن رَحِمَ اللَّهِ. What's the i'rab of that verb, تُطِعْ? وَإِن تُطِعْ أَكْثَرَ مَن فِي الْأَرْضِ. What's the i'rab of تُطِعْ here? Hanif. What's the i'rab of تُطِعْ? وَإِن تُطِعْ أَكْثَرَ مَن فِي الْأَرْضِ يُضِلُّكَ عَن سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ. فضل مصطفى. Okay, اسم؟ نعم. Where's the أداة شرط؟ إن. نعم. So what's the i'rab of تُطِعْ? مجزوم علامة جزمه. مصطفى يقول حذف حرف العلة. توافق يا عبد الوهاب؟ السكون. Where's the ya? لماذا؟ اجلس. Why is the ya remove نادر؟ التقاء الساكنين. Because remember, there's a sukun upon the ya. There's a sukun upon the عين. Because الفعل المضارع هنا is مجزوم. So therefore, sukun upon the عين, sukun upon the ya, لا يجوز التقاء الساكنين. You can't have two sukuns together. So the حرف العلة is removed. That's how you end up with تطيع. What about يضلوك? يضلوك. What's the إعراب of that? عبد المالك. Where's داود? أين داود؟ داود فضل. لماذا تختفي؟ نعم جواب الشرط. علامة جزمه. How do you know it's مجزوم؟ أحسنت. حذف النون. Because the origin is what? يضلونك. However, حذف النون لأنه مجزوم. لأنه من الأمثلة الخمسة. الأفعال الخمسة. نعم. طيب. Also from the proofs that the majority is not the crucial factor, the determining factor is the saying of Allah Azza wa Jal. وَمَا أَكْثَرُ النَّاسِ وَلَوْ حَرَصْتَ بِمُؤْمِنِينَ. And most of mankind will not believe even if you desire it eagerly. فَإِنْ كَثُرَ أَهْلِ الْحَقِّ فَيَا حَبَّذَا. Look what Shaykh Rabbi says here, Ikhwan. If the people of the truth are many, then this is excellent. يَا حَبَّذَا. وَالْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ. And all praise is due to Allah. نعم. If the people of the truth are many, alhamdulillah. That's a ni'mah. Not that, for example, a person, he chooses to be an isolationist and he stays even away from the people of the sunnah, and then he starts using a hadith about ghurba, strangeness, as a proof why he stays away from the Salafis. That's insanity. I don't know what planet you're on. No scholar ever says that. نعم. How can you be ba'id from the people of the sunnah? وَتَبْتَعِدْ عَنْهُمْ. And then you try and use the hadith about al-ghurba and the nusus about ghurba to justify your strange and odd position. هذا من أبطل الأباطيل. Rather, الحمد لله. نعم. How do we understand this? Numbers is not a determining factor. The majority is not a determining factor. That does not distinguish between truth and falsehood, just numbers. However, if the people of truth are many, that's excellent. And all praise is due to Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. And that's a blessing from Allah Azza wa Jal. لكن لا يقال أبدا إن الحق بالكثرة. But it is never to be said that the truth is the majority, as some people claim. كما يقول كثير من أهل الضلال, as many of the people in misguidance they claim. فإن الميزان في الإسلام هو الحق. The scale in Islam is the truth. وقد قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, as the messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, بدأ الإسلام غريبا وسيعود غريبا وسيعود كما بدأ غريبا فطوبى للغرباء. بدأ الإسلام غريبا. Islam is started strange. وسيعود كما بدأ غريبا. And it will return just as it started strange. فطوبى للغرباء. And a tree in paradise known as الطوبى is for the strangers. وعلى كل حال قد يفهم أهل الباطل أن السواد الأعظم هو الكثرة, لكن المؤلف يرد هذا الفهم الباطل بقوله والسواد الأعظم الحق وأهله. Thus the people of falsehood, they may understand that the main body of Sawad al-A'zam is the majority. However, the author refutes this false understanding, saying the main body is the truth and its people. Naam, the main body is the truth and its people. Ikhwan, I just want to read a footnote that is mentioned in the explanation of Sheikh al-Fawzan. Abu Na'aymi mentioned in Al-Hilya, and this is a beautiful narration. أنا رجلا سأل الإمام إسحاق بن راهوي. A man, he asked الإمام إسحاق بن راهوي, the companion of الإمام أحمد رحمه الله. إسحاق بن راهوي. من السواد الأعظم? Who are the main body? Who is the main body of Muslims? من السواد الأعظم? Who is the main body? فقال محمد بن أسلم الطوسي. إسحاق بن راهوي, he said the main body is محمد بن أسلم الطوسي. وأصحابه ومن تبعه. And his companions and those who follow him. Imagine if somebody said this in this time. What accusations they would make against him. لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. ثم قال سأل رجل ابن المبارك. سأل رجل ابن المبارك. Then he said a man asked ابن المبارك. فقال يا أبا عبد الرحمن من السواد الأعظم? A man he asked Abdullah ibn Mubarak, "O Abu Abdurrahman, who is the main body?" Ibn Mubarak, he said, "Abu Hamza al-Sukkari is the main body." ثم قال إسحاق, and then إسحاق ibn Rahway, he said, "في ذلك الزمان," meaning Ibn Mubarak was referring to that time, meaning the time of Abu Hamza. وفي زماننا محمد ابن أسلم ومن تبعه, and in our time, السواد الأعظم, the main body is Muhammad ibn Aslam and those who follow him. ثم قال إسحاق, إسحاق ابن راهوي, he said, لو سألت الجهال من السواد الأعظم, if you were to ask the ignorant people, who is the main body, لقالوا جماعة الناس, they would say the majority of the people. If you were to ask the ignorant people, the one without علم, who's the main body, who's the جماعة, they would say to you the majority of the people. ولا يعلمون أن الجماعة عالم متمسك بأثر النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وطريقته فمن كان معه وتبعه فهو الجماعة ومن خالفه فيه ترك الجماعة ثم قال إسحاق لم أسمع عالما منذ 50 سنة أعلم من محمد بن أسلم. Then إسحاق بن راهوي said the people, they do not know that the جماعة is a scholar who clings to the narrations of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and his path. And those who are with him and those who follow him, they are the jama'ah. And whoever opposes him, then they have abandoned the jama'ah. Look at that. Subhanallah. Imagine somebody said that statement in this time. Already you have that individual, he's supposedly, I think he's doing his doctorate in al-Qura, Hadahullah, from Connecticut. He wrote in that book, I can't remember the name of it, something to do with chains, the missing link. I think that's the name of it, Hadahullah. He accuses the people of the Sunnah as taking the scholars as lords besides Allah Azza wa Jal, wal-iyadu billah. Accusing the Salafis of shirk. What do you accuse Ishaq ibn Rahawi of? Hadakullah. Wa aslaha halana wa halak. Ishaq ibn Rahawi, he said, and they do not know that the Jama'ah is a scholar who clings to the narrations of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his path. Whoever is with him and follows him, they are the Jama'ah. Ishaq ibn Rahawi mentioned one person. Abdullah ibn Mubarak, he mentioned one person. Not limiting the jama'ah to these individuals, but saying that the jama'ah, sawad al-a'zam, are those who are upon the Qur'an, the sunnah, with the understanding of the sahaba. Fi ayy zamani wa fi ayy makan. Then al-Barbahari, and inshallah we'll close on this point, he said, فَمَنْ خَالَفَ أَصْحَابَ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ فِي شَيْءٍ مِنْ أَمْرِ الدِّينِ فَقَدْ كَفَرْ. And that is why, brothers and sisters, you can't just rely upon reading books without the understanding of the ulama, because somebody may read this statement and misunderstand it. Al-Barbahari rahimahullah, he says, so whoever contradicts the companions of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in any of the affairs of the religion, then he has fallen into disbelief. Whoever contradicts the companions of the Messenger of Allah in any of the affairs of the religion, then he has fallen into disbelief. And look, alhamdulillah, look how the people of the sunnah now highlighted to you, the ulama of the sunnah, qawluhum wahid. The way that they explain this is wahid, because the aqidah of Ahlul Sunnah is wahid. The methodology of Ahlul Sunnah is wahid. All of the imams, al-Imam Ahmad, al-Imam Abu Hanifa, al-Imam al-Shafi'i, al-Imam Malik, all of the ulama, alhamdulillah, aqidatum wahida, wa manhajahum wahid. All of their belief is one, and the methodology is one. La ikhtilafa baynahum. There's no difference among them in matters of belief and methodology. And you'll see the exact same way that Sheikh Rabbi explained it, this statement of Al-Barbahari is exactly the same way that Sheikh Al-Fawzan explained it. حَفِدَهُمُ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى May Allah Azza wa Jalla preserve both of them. And that's a delir right there, ikhwan, at the fallacy and the kadhib and the iftira of that statement, that the people of the Sunnah, they limit the scholars to a given number. Here we are, we're studying Sheikh Fawzan, Sheikh Rabbi, and many of the ماذا علماءه السنة. So the Sheikh Rabbi said, يُحَذِّرَ الْمُؤَلِّفِ رَحِمَهُ اللَّهِ مِنْ تَعَمُّدِ مُخَالَفَةِ أَصْحَابِ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمِ. Here, Al-Barbahari, the author, is warning against intentionally opposing the companions. Because if you intentionally oppose the companions, فَإِنَّكَ عَلَى خَطَرٍ, then you're in a dangerous situation. وَلَا يَبْعُدْ أَنَّهُ يُرِيدْ بِالْكُفْرِ الْكُفْرَ الْأَصْغَرِ لِأَنَّ الْكُفْرَ كُفْرَانِ. And it is not far-fetched, or it is not far from the truth, that Al-Barbahari, he is referring to minor disbelief. When Al-Barbahari said, whoever contradicts the companions of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in any of the affairs of the religion, then he has fallen into disbelief. The Sheikh, he said, it is not far from the truth that he is referring to minor disbelief, as disbelief is of two types. What are they, Abdullah? What are the two types of disbelief? Major disbelief or minor disbelief? Ahsant. Major disbelief or minor disbelief? Kufr akbar yukhrij min millat al-Islam. You have major disbelief that removes somebody from the fold of Islam. وَذَلِكْ لِمُخَالَفَتِهِمْ فِي أَمْرٍ مَعْلُومٍ مِنَ الدِّينِ بِالدُّرُورَةِ. And this is due to them opposing a matter from the religion which is known by necessity. كَسَبِّ اللَّهِ, like abusing Allah. أَوْ سَبِّ دِينِ اللَّهِ أَوْ رَسُولِهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ. Abusing the religion of Allah, abusing the messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم. That is kufr, مُخْرِج مِنَ الْمِلَّةِ. It removes someone from the fold of Islam. If somebody insults Allah, insults the religion, insults the messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم, that is kufr that takes a person outside the fold of the Islam. Or bi takfir al-sahaba al-kiram illa qaleena minhum. Or by declaring the companions to be disbelievers, except for a few of them. Or al-istihza billah, or mocking Allah, wa rasulihi wa kitabihi, and his messenger and his book, ila akhiri nawaqid al-Islam, and the other nullifiers of faith. That's major disbelief. Is that clear to everyone? Na'am. And then you have the second type, وكفر أصغر كالحلف بغير الله وكيسير الرياء, like swearing by other than Allah and a small amount of showing off. والمؤلف, نعم, referring to the رافضة, شيعة, نعم. والمؤلف إمام يعلم هذا الفرق بين الكفرين. And the author al-Barbahari is an imam in the religion. He knows the difference between minor disbelief or major disbelief. وَقَدْ يَقْصُدَ الْمُؤَلِّفَ الْكُفْرَيْنِ وَلِكُلِّ مِنْهُمَا أَسْبَابُهُ وَمُجِيبَاتُهُ. نعم. And the Sheikh said, the author is an imam and he knows the difference between major disbelief and minor disbelief. And it may be the author is referring to the two types of disbelief and each one has its reasons and causes. وَلِكُلِّ مِنْهُمَا أَسْبَابُهُ وَمُجِيبَاتُهُ. نعم. Then Sheikh Al-Fawzan, I'll just read Sheikh Al-Fawzan because it's the same as Sheikh Rabi, there's different wording. He said, the statement of Al-Barbahari, فَمَنْ خَالَفَ أَصْحَابَ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ فِي شَيْءٍ مِنْ أَمْرِ الدِّينِ فَقَدْ كَفَرَ. Whoever contradicts the companions of the Messenger of Allah, whoever contradicts the companions of the Messenger of Allah, صلى الله عليه وسلم, in any of the affairs of the religion has fallen into disbelief. كَفَرَ يَحْتَمِلَ الْكُفْرَ الْأَكْبَرَ وَيَحْتَمِلَ الْكُفْرَ الْأَصْغَرَ. Sheikh Al-Fawzan said, it is possible it is referring to major disbelief, and it's possible it is referring to minor disbelief. بِحَسْبِ الْمُخَالَفَةِ, depending on the opposition itself. I'll give an example. حَتَّى إِنْشَاءَ يَكُونَ وَاضِحًا. If somebody opposed the companions and made dua لِغَيْرِ اللَّهِ, they supplicated to other than Allah, Aswad, what's the hukum of that? What type of kufr would that be? Minor? Who said that? If somebody opposed the companions and they supplicated to other than Allah, يدعو غير الله, يدعو الأموات في القبور, calling upon the dead in the graves, what type of kufr would that be? Major. فقد كفر بالكفر الأكبر. Major disbelief. Likewise, if somebody opposed the companions, رضوان الله عليهم, and they said that the Quran was created, what type of disbelief is that? Faddal.
He says the Quran is created.
Yes.
Major
disbelief. So naam, yahtamil, it can be understood that this is referring to major disbelief, depending upon the mukhalafa, the type of opposition itself. But at the same time, it could be referring to minor disbelief. Meaning, minor disbelief, it doesn't exit them from the fold of Islam. Like the bid'ah of using the dhikr beads. That doesn't take somebody outside the fold of Islam. But it's an innovation, it's misguidance. Naam? لَيْسَ مَعْنَاهُ أَنَّهُ كَفَرَ الْكُفْرَ الْمُخْرِجِ مِنَ الْمِلَّةِ مُطْلَقًا. This statement of Al-Barbahari, when he said, whoever contradicts the companions of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in anything from the affairs of the religion, then they are fallen into disbelief. فَقَدْ كَفَرَ, they are fallen into disbelief. It does not mean the individual has disbelieved with the disbelief that exits from the religion in all cases. It doesn't mean that. So be careful. The statement of Al-Barbahari when he said, whoever contradicts the companions of the Messenger of Allah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in anything of the affairs of the religion has fallen into disbelief. Fallen into disbelief ليس معناه أنه كفر الكفر المخرج من الملة مطلقة. It does not mean that the individual has disbelief with the disbelief that exits from the fold of the religion in all cases. Because you have to look at what the opposition is. What has he contradicted the companions in? In what? It may be that Nam he's contradicted the companions in a matter which is major disbelief. But it may be that it may be the minor disbelief that doesn't exit from the fold of Islam. So it's important that you understand the ibara. It's important that you correctly understand the intent of Imam al-Barbahari. قد يكون هذا وقد يكون الكفر الأصغر. المهم أن مخالفة السلف كفر. وقد يكون أكبر وقد يكون أصغر حسب المخالفة. Sheikh al-Fawzan said, that which is important, opposing the Salaf is considered to be kufr. And it may be major and it may be minor depending upon the opposition or the contradiction itself. In what affair is the contradiction? In what affair is the opposition? Alhamdulillah, is that clear? That's wadih. And with that, inshallah, naktafi. And tomorrow we'll start with the next point, which is the statement of al-Barbahari rahimahullah. وَاعْلَمْ أَنَّ النَّاسِ لَمْ يَبْتَدِعُوا بِدْعَةً قَطْ حَتَّى تَرَكُوا مِنَ السُّنَّةِ مِثْلَهَا. Know that the people, they have never innovated an innovation ever, except that they abandoned its like from the sunnah. فَاحْذَرِ الْمُحَرَّمَاتِ مِنَ الْأُمُورِ فَإِنَّ كُلَّ مُحْدَثَةٍ بِدْعَةٍ وَكُلَّ بِدْعَةٍ ضَلَالَةٍ وَالضَّلَالَةُ وَأَهْلُهَا فِي النَّارِ.